here like a lot of tourists do, and I saw nothing. And the emptiness just seemed cavernous. It was just too empty.
From Hawthorne, California, the fabulous Freeway.
This is the tone of Dennis Wilson's voice. My name is Dennis Wilson. I live at 3701 West 100.
Recording 1, 2, 1,
Ready, Carl?
1, 2.
What's wrong?
The idea of a historic landmark to the Beach Boys came to me as a completely spontaneous inspiration, hitting me like a silver bullet in my imagination. Being a native of Eastern Iowa with our Jarnigan home not too far from the music set, I liken the experience that I had to what happened to the Iowa farmer named Ray Kinsella in the movie Field of Dreams, played by Kevin Costner. As I got farther and farther into the landmark project, the three messages that Ray Kinsella received during the movie would come to me from time to time during the project. And those messages from the movie, if you remember, were, if you build it, he will come, ease his pain, and go the distance.
In the late 50s and early 60s, Hawthorne was just a sleepy little suburb of L.A., but all that was soon to change, and Hawthorne would become world famous as the home of the Beach Boys. Their house at 3701 West 119th Street would become a mecca for fans worldwide, but all they would see when they got there was the side of the 105 freeway. Fans like Harry Jarnigan went home disappointed. Back in Tracy, California, Harry sat slumped and depressed in a lawn chair in his backyard.
And so I've been a fan almost all my life, but the idea for a landmark, it just occurred to me one day. I had read a book about the Beach Boys, and it just occurred to me that they have played a major part in California music history, and it's just too bad there's not a sign here to commemorate some of their early work, and so I thought this would be the perfect place for it.
Harry came to the city of Hawthorne with his idea and found we are truly the city of good neighbors.
At this time, it's my great honor to introduce somebody that we did a lot of telecommuting, discussions over the phone, and through probably 6 newspapers. This man has a vision and a passion, and I'm proud to call him a good friend of ours. Harry Jarnigan, would you like to come up? And this man has worked very hard. Persistence.
What I'd like to do this evening is give you a preview of a presentation that I will be giving to the state of California, not this coming Friday, but next Friday, concerning a proposal that I have put forward to the state to designate the site of the Wilson home, once at 3701 West 119th, as a state historic landmark. We're honored here to have with us tonight three members of that legacy. We have three sons of Dennis Wilson. We have Carl Wilson. You just raise your hand, Carl Wilson. We have Chris Wilson, and we have Gage Wilson here tonight. And I also have with me two other members of my ad hoc committee that I've pulled together to get this thing to happen. This is Paula Springer, and this is my son, Doug, who's been helping me out quite a bit.
Harry next journeyed to Ontario, California for the State Historical Commission meeting. He thought maybe the stayed committee would not be receptive to his idea.
2, 3, go.
His worries were quickly dispelled.
I ask you to think about where it all began, 3701 West 119th Street in Hawthorne.
Wilson and his two brothers, Dennis and Carl Wilson, grew to manhood and honed their skills that would eventually make them the core of the musical group that would be world famous as the Beach Boys. This home sadly no longer exists, but the address was 3701 West 119th Street in Hawthorne, California. It was a childhood home of the Beach Boys in Hawthorne, birthplace of a musical legacy, and we propose it today
as a State of California historical landmark. I ask you to think about where it all began, 3701 West 119th Street in Hawthorne. And I ask you for your vote to register this as a State of California historical landmark. Thank you. Introduce you. We have here with us today, we have Justin Wilson, who is Carl Wilson's son, and we have Carl Wilson, who is Dennis Wilson's son.
So it was the Beach Boys have been such a big part of our lives in California also. You cited that people came here because of that. Well, people in California have got a lot of pride in their state because of the Beach Boys.
I was at a little bistro in Paris on a cold December night, and this man from Belgium, with very few teeth, my French is pretty bad, but we managed to communicate with these where we're from. Oh, he says, a California girl, don't you wish they could all be California?
I remember when I was in college in Pennsylvania and having grown up in California, and I went to hear the Beach Boys play at Princeton University, and there was a huge crowd, so much so that I think we kind of broke the subfloor because we were so enthusiastic, and I felt very, very proud of that heritage and that association.
Would anyone like to offer up a motion to designate the Wilson family home, the site of the childhood home of the Beach Boys, as a state historical landmark?
I will so move.
Okay, California girl. Only California girls can come in on this. Oh, and Kathleen. Hi, that's great. Commissioner Maneri has moved, and we have a second by Commissioner Green to approve the site of the childhood home of the Beach Boys in Hawthorne. Los Angeles County, to be transmitted to the director of the Parks Department of Parks and Recreation for listing as a California historical landmark, and for simultaneous listing on the California Register of Historic Places. Please, all in favor, what should I have you saying? Maybe a nice high A? No. Please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. I'm going to vote. I never vote. Okay, it truly carries unanimously. And thank you all so much for coming and for your efforts.
Thank you.
And the best of luck. Let us know what we can do. I love the fact you've already written your plaque.
Yeah, I
got. And I obviously, I'm sure you'll be pursuing the freeway sign as a state landmark.
Yes, we'll make sure we have it.
It'd be so neat if you could, especially with your digital capacity, obviously, you could get a little soundtrack emanating from the plaque. I don't know. I'm seeing, pick your favorite Beach Boys song. I don't know. Designed as a big jukebox? Okay, I'll stop.
And the state landmark is actually a very old landmarking program, one of the oldest in the nation, that allows the commission to designate historic places, historic objects, bridges, and historic buildings as important to the state's history and all its richness. And so this is really one of the first times we've designated something quite as modern as the Beach Boys family home, as the Wilson family home. This really, I think, an incredible site that even though the building's gone, what the site can tell us is nationally and even internationally, I think, important.
Sing a little bit of that song.
Okay. Let's see. If everybody had a notion across the USA.
Once past the singing commissioners, Harry still had to build it.
Well, that was the first major phase, was getting the landmark status approved. Then the next major phase was actually doing the design. We had a design competition to get the artist concept put down. The Wilson family chose the final design.
They picked mine and another design that they liked, elements of that, and they combined two entries to come up with the final monument design. But I'm just really, really happy to be involved because that meant, it's a historical monument, so that's something that's going to be there. And it was just a big opportunity to do something important.
We had to go into detail in engineering. We had to order materials. We had to design it in great detail. Among the very, very first people who were with me on this project who got to listen to me talk about it day after day were my friends at Hatchmont McDonald, an engineering firm up in the Bay Area, who in fact did the engineering drawings
upon which this project was built. The offer to donate this engineering expertise to our project came to me last fall when John Townsend, our Western Region Executive Vice President, and I were driving to a meeting right here on the 105 right behind me. And I remember saying, hey, John, this is where we're going to build our landmark monument. And quite unexpectedly, he said, you know, Harry, we would be honored to do the engineering for this monument.
So that's a structural design out there. That thing has got like 3,500-pound concrete in it, all kinds of reinforcing steel. It's a very strong structure. And so we went through all that. And then we went through the planning for this event. And those last two things sort of went in parallel. But my major task in this last half of the effort has been the design and construction.
One member of the Wilson family played a special role in this landmark project, being as involved, as close to his heart, as any person could get. He oversaw its construction.
The monument was built by a man who definitely had a vested interest in the project, being that he's the son of legendary beach boy Dennis Wilson.
Harry Jarnagin approached me a couple of months before the monument was actually, we were ready to break ground. As soon as I got the invites, it was very crucial because we didn't want to get it done too early, and we didn't want to get it done not in time. So we kind of planned it out and scheduled it accordingly. And there were some times towards the end where we worked 7 days a week, 15 hours a day, even through Sunday, to get it done in time. But I mean, like I said, the karma on this whole project with everything just amazingly just kind of just fell right into place. I mean, we didn't come across any unforeseen conditions that we went, oh my God, now what do we do? Everything just happened one after another, and it just came out perfect.
Harry got it built, and they came from all over the world to see the unveiling. Al, Brian, David, and their families, and the world's press and media was there, proving one person can make a difference.
It's the kind of music that helps you through the hard times and lifts you up. I mean, it makes the good times even better. And I would have to say that for my entire generation and maybe the one following, that's the way it's been. I mean, Beach Boys music is happy, positive music.
And how do you think they'll react when they see the landmark?
I hope they like it.
2, 3, go.
Surfing is the only life, the only way for me.
Well, now come along, baby, and surf.
Surf with me.
Bomb, dip, 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 bomb, dip, dip, dip.
Surfing.
Born and turned on my radio. I was surfing for the surfing scene to see if I was going up.
Across the USA, then everybody'd be surfing like California, yeah. You'd see them wearing their baggies, Huarache sandals too, a bushy, bushy blonde hairdo, surfing USA. You'd catch them surfing at Del Mar, Ventura County Line, Santa Cruz and Trestle.